This is the 2020 Lexus UX 250H Luxury. This is a hybrid. I'm Josh Smith, GuidingMobile.com. I want to walk you through some of the cool features and things you need to know about this vehicle. Up front in the UX 250H, we have a lot of room. There's lots of soft touch throughout. The cabin feels very spacious and very luxurious, matching that luxury trim level that we're on. You can go with a standard trim, an F-Sport trim, and then the luxury trim. The luxury trim that we're in with all the options is around $43,000, $44,000. And while that's not cheap, it's a bargain for everything you're gonna get. We have a well-appointed cabin. I really like the seats. They are ventilated and heated, which is great. It's currently 90 plus degrees right now, so I'm sweating a little bit. The seat is cooling me off. I don't have the fan blowing because I don't want to pick all that up on the microphone. The seat has a very nice quilted look to it. I really enjoy the driving experience of the UX 250H. Now, this has sport, it has normal, and has eco mode, so I've driven it mostly in normal. That got me around 38 miles per gallon with a mix of city and highway, and that's using some of the electric vehicle as well as the gas power. You don't need to plug it in to charge, it just charges up based on when you're driving by recapturing energy or filling that battery back up. Now, in sport mode, I did have some fun on some twisty corners on winding country roads. And that's a nice feature in this vehicle. The handling is good, the steering feels nice, and I was able to feel quite confident while I was on the road. Now, other features I like while driving include adaptive cruise control and blind spot monitoring. There's also a lane warning system so that it will let me know if I'm about to depart my lane, and that's part of the Lexus safety suite. Up front here, I do like we have a moonroof. It does open, it's only for the front, there's no panoramic. That may be due to the design of the hatchback style opening. Overall, I'm a real big fan of the interior of this car. It feels good, it fits nice, and it's sized really well. For a small car, you don't feel like you're in a small car. Part of that's the openness of the hatch, but up front, I feel tons of room, and I enjoyed my time driving this around over the 4th of July holiday weekend. The UX 250H is a hatchback style vehicle, and this has a motorized liftgate, and in here we have a decent amount of storage, which is pretty impressive for the size of this vehicle. I do like, I was able to stash a lot of supplies back here. Right now I just have some film gear, and then I have my hikers because I like to go hiking right now. And then down below this, there's a spot where we have all of the stuff we need to change a tire or something like that, and a little bit of room to store a few extra things. Now with this, we have this privacy screen that we can remove pretty easily if we don't want it in here. So I'm gonna pop that out, and then it just snaps into place up front with two little clips, and then I can pop that out. And with that, I'm gonna get a lot more storage because I can fold these seats down. And if I have my seats up front moved enough, now I have a decent amount of storage that I can slide stuff in. Back here, we also have a 12 volt outlet, and that's going to allow someone in the back seat to plug in, maybe charge a laptop or charge their phone up without using any ports in the front section. Also handy if you need some power back here for camping or summertime activities. As you can see, there's plenty of room. And one nice thing, although this is not perfectly flat, the incline comes in, so it's gonna be pretty easy to stash something in here if you need to haul something that's a little bit larger. In the back seat of the 250H, I currently have this seat in my driving position. I'm about 6 foot tall. It's touching the front of my knees a little bit, but I could easily give the backseat passenger a little bit more room. Headroom is really good. I have to really stretch before even my hair touches. Back here, the seats are comfortable. Have a nice pull down armrest with room for two cups. And there are no cup holders in the door. There's not a whole lot of storage cubbies back here, which is something you may need to keep in mind. Now, one thing that is nice is this center console opens side to side, either direction, so it's easy to reach in from the back seat. With this up, we could fit three people in here. Personally, I would not want to fit more than two adults in the back seat. What is nice is we have two charging ports down here. They are both standard USB. There's two vents right here in the center that we can use to keep the passengers in the back seat pretty cool. There are handles, which you can kind of see right here, and there's one on each side, so that will make it a little bit easier to get in and out of the vehicle. The doors open pretty wide, so it's pretty easy for me to step out. And then once I'm out, if I want to get in, it's pretty easy to get in and out for me. Again, the handles are here. There's some little hooks that you can attach stuff to. The back seat feels very comfortable. This one has a white interior that matches the front. A lot of soft touch materials throughout the cabin here. There is a little bit of a harder surface along the door, but where your arm is going to touch along this armrest and where your shoulder is going to touch, you again have some softer touch materials. Here you can see the large, beautiful screen on the dash. We have an analog clock to the left of it, and this is not a touch screen, so you use the touchpad to control. But with that, you can use CarPlay. On the Lexus side, you can use a map. You can bounce over to the menu and switch between different options, including info that will show us some fuel economy. Right now, you're not gonna see the greatest fuel economy for the last 10 or 15 minutes because I've had the car running to keep things cool and allow me to use the camera in here. But with that, you can also quickly access all of your different options, including audio, phone. The sound system in here is quite good. I've been able to blast some tunes and have some fun while cruising around. Here's a look at the instrument cluster, and so this will change slightly depending on the drive mode that I'm in. So if I'm in Eco versus Sport or Normal, that changes a little bit, and you can see indicators on the screen to let you know where you're at. Over on the side, you can scroll through and see different information about your drive, as well as other information about the car and what you're doing. On the left side of the screen here, you can see my adaptive cruise as well as my lane keeping information. Rounding this out, we have a look at our safety features, including lane center, steering assist, and then we also have lane alert. We can adjust the sensitivity and a few other options. Here's a look at our wireless phone charger, which is very handy. And then we also have a quick pop-up for our 12 volt outlet right there. Two cup holders in the center. You need to use the Lexus touchpad to control the screen. It works out all right. It's not my favorite way to control something, but it gets the job done. And now that I have CarPlay, I can deal with this. Quick access to map, menu, and back. And then one of my favorite features is built in right to the armrest here, so I can adjust tuning and volume. And then I can skip forward and skip back, as well as push a button here or here to go to radio or media. So I really like that. It looks and feels very nice. As we look over here, you can see that EV mode button, so you can toggle on EV mode. And then there is a brake hold option you're able to use as well. I'm a big fan of the design of this vehicle. You get a hatch style look, and this green looks really great. Overall, the design comes together really well, and we have a very big grille up front. And I think it looks really nice and well proportioned on this vehicle. As we come around, you kind of get another profile shot, and the body lines, the color, and the design of this car really come together quite nicely. It's something I really appreciate. There is some blue branding because this is the hybrid model, but if you're looking for a small luxury hybrid in that subcompact or that hatchback style design, the Lexus UX 250h is definitely something that you need to check out. Thanks for joining me to take a look at the Lexus UX 250h. You can find out more. We'll have links down in the description below, and we'll have a full review over at gottabemobile.com. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Leave us a comment. Let us know what you want to know about this vehicle. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.